Welcome back to computer science class. So today we will discussing the topic, that is for loop. Okay, so first of all, for loop is used to execute the statements repeatedly until the fixed number of times or until the condition become false, same as that of the while and do while, but only the difference is, so easily you can get the how many times the loop will be executed. So that is the one difference. Okay, so here the syntax of for loop is initialization, next is condition, so next is increment or decrement. Here you have to write the statement. So for is a keyword. So within the for loop there are three steps. So the first step is initialization. Here initialization indicates assigning some value to the particular variable. For example, so initially I can take I is equal to 1. For example, if you want to print the numbers from 1 to 10, so first you can initialize I is equal to 1. Using while and do while also it is possible to print the numbers, but only the difference is in while and do while, at the time of declaring the variable directly you can assign I is equal to 1, but here within the for loop we have to initialize I is equal to 1. Condition is as this, I is less than or equal to n. Once the condition is true, it will execute the statements. After executing the statements, the value will be incremented. Incremented means you can write I plus plus here. But in while and do while, so there is no increment and decrement step. Because by the syntax, the while loop syntax said that while in the bracket of condition. So within the brackets, we have to write only the condition. But here, the for loop says that, so within the bracket, you have to increment. No need to mention here. So after incrementing, again, it will check the condition. Again, if the condition is true, it will execute the statements. This process will repeat until the condition become false. When the condition become false, automatically the loop will be terminated. Terminated means it will come out of the loop. Okay, so just I have to write one example. See here. So I have to write only the logic. I is equal to 1, I is less than or equal to 5, I plus plus. See out. See here, initially I is equal to 1. 1 means less than or equal to 5. The condition is true. If the condition is true, true means it will print the 1. The result is 1. So after printing the 1, automatically I will be incremented. So I become 2. Again it will check the condition, 2 is less than or equal to 5, again condition is true, it will print 2, it will print 3, 4, 5. Once the I value becomes 6, 6 is less than or equal to 5, the condition become false. So this is the for loop. Okay, so now you have to see the one example. So program to check whether the given number is prime or not. The given number is prime or not. So here prime number means the number which is divisible by 1 and itself. The number which is divisible by 1 and itself. Okay. For example, if I consider 7 is a prime number. If you want to say 7 is a prime number means, so the previous numbers from 2 to 6, the first prime number is 2. So 1 is not a prime number because 1 is neither composite nor prime. The first prime number is 2. If you say that 7 is a prime number means from 2 to 6. So whatever the previous numbers are there, so with the previous numbers 7 is not divisible. Not completely divisible. Suppose if it is completely divisible means it is not a prime number. It means that we have to check 7 mod 2 is not equal to 0. 7 mod 2, 3 is not equal to 0. 7 mod 4 is not equal to 0. 7 mod 5 not equal to 0. 7 mod 6 is not equal to 0. If it satisfies all the conditions, then you say that, and we say that 7 is a prime number. So this 7 a previous number 7 avare a number in the divide agabaradre completely. So in case adu completely divide aaytappa antandre, so adu naave enantivi composite number anti. So previous number le hang maadkopri, the given value is 7, the first prime number is 2. 7 mod 2 not equal to 0, 7 mod 3 not equal to 0, 7 mod 4 not equal to 0. So like this. Okay, so for this I have to write program. Simple logic is there. So first I can write header file hash include io stream dot h. Next is void where int of n comma I cout enter the see. So first I can write for I is equal to, so what we have to initialize the first value here, 2. Why we have to initialize 2? Because the first prime number is 2, so that's why I can assign I is equal to 2. Next I can write I is less than n. Next, for next we have to check the condition. If n mod I is equal to 0. So actually we have to check the n mod I is not equal to 0. So I can check in reverse order, because once it is divisible, it is composite number. So it is 7 athwa naavu bare number na consider madidaga, so yavade one number at least except one and itself, at least it is divisible by other number, means it is a composite number. That's why I can write n mod I is equal to 0. So if it is true, I can print C out composite. Next you can write exit of 0. Finally C out it is prime. So if you are using exit of 0, means again we have to include one more header file hash include stdlib.h, standard library header file. Here exit of 0 means it will stop the execution of the program. See here, I can consider first 6. 6 is actually a composite number, so with the help of program you have to print the given number is composite number. Okay, I is equal to 2, 2 is less than 6, again condition is true. 6 mod 2, answer is 0, 0 is equal to 0, condition is true, so it is a composite. So once it will print the result as a composite, next step is exit of 0. Exit of 0 means the entire program execution stop. So why we have to stop the program execution? Because 6 is divisible by 2. Again, no need to check for 3. So, once it is divisible by other number, means again no need to check the remaining cases. So that's why I can write exit of 0. Okay. Next, I can consider 7. 2 is less than 7. Condition is true. 7 mod 2, false. False means it will skip. Again, I plus plus I become 3. 3 is less than 7. Again, condition is true. 7 mod 3, false. Again, loop will continue. Next is 7 mod 4. Again, the condition become false. Again, 7 mod 5, false. 7 mod 6, false. When the I value becomes 7, 7 is less than 7. Condition become false. Once the condition become false, means it will come out of the loop and it will print it is a prime number. Okay, so this is the important program to check whether the given number is prime or not. So in the prime or not, the first step is you can initialize the value as a 2. So So why we have to initialize 2? Because the first prime number is 2. That's why I can assign 2. And don't write less than, don't write less than or equal to n. Okay, just you can write less than n. Up to 6 you can divisible. Again, you cannot divisible 7 by 7. Okay. So this is the program for prime number. The next program is to print the numbers in reverse order. So already this program is completed in while loop. Okay, again we have to solve it for in the reverse order. You have to print the numbers. Okay, for, so I can consider I is equal to, so why I can consider I is equal to m means because the first number is last number, your entered value is the first number. That's why I can write I is equal to n. Next, I is greater than 0 and minus. So one thing you have to remember is whatever you have to assign the value, if it is high means automatically it will be decremented. That's why I can write I minus minus here. So see out. So I can consider n value as a 5. 5 is greater than 0, condition is true, it will print 5. Again, I minus minus 4. 4 is greater than 0, again condition is true, it will print 4. Next, I minus minus, I become 3. Next time 3 is greater than 0, it will print 3. Next, I minus minus, I value is 2. 2 is greater than 0, again condition is true, it will print again. Next time 1. When the I value becomes 0, 0 is greater than 0, false. False means it will come out of the loop. Okay, so this is the program for printing the numbers in reverse order. Okay, so there are so many examples are there, whatever we have to solve the programs in while and do while, so easily you can convert. Okay. Sum of natural numbers. I think this program is also considered completed. Okay. Next, you can try factorial of a number. Factorial. Almost all the programs are same in while and for. Okay. Only the difference in while and do while we have to solve reverse of a number, sum of digits to check whether the given is Armstrong number or not. So for that, those programs you have to prefer while and do while. Okay, so now you have to solve factorial of a number. For example, 5 factorial. 5 factorial means 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So sum of natural number means 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5. 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 means it is a sum of natural number. Factorial means 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5, or in the reverse order you can multiply, you will get the same result. Okay, so if you want to solve the factorial of a number, so I can assign f is equal to 1. So whatever the number is multiplied with 1, again you will get the same number. So that's why I can assign f is equal to 1. For I is equal to 1, I is less than or equal to n, I plus plus. See here, I is equal to 1, so I can consider n value as a 5, 1 is less than or equal to 5 condition is true. See here, f value is 1. Suppose if I consider f is equal to 0 means every time we will get 0 into 1, 0 into 2, 0 into 3, 0 into 4, 0 into 5. Like that, we will get the final result as a 0 only. So that's why if it is a multiplication, we can take the initial value as a 1. If it is sum, you can take the initial value as a 0. So now the program is factorial. So that's why I can assign f is equal to 1. 1 is less than or equal to 5. Condition is true. See here. 1 into 1. 1 only. It is stored in f. F is equal to 1. Next. This COT is finally printing result. It is outside the loop. So I will be incremented. I become 2. 2 is less than or equal to 5. Condition is true. F value is 1. 1 into 2. 2 is stored in I. Sorry, 2 is stored in F. The present value of F is 2. Next, I plus plus, I become 3. 3 is, F value is 2. I value is 3. 2 into 3, 6. I plus plus, I become 4. F value is 6. 6 into 4. 24. I plus plus, I become 5. 5 is less than or equal to 5, condition is true. 24 into 5, so we will get the result as 120. When the I value becomes 6, the condition becomes false. Finally, it will print the result as a 120. Okay, so this is the program for factorial of a number. Okay, in the next class, we will discuss some more programs. Thank you.